Welcome in. I'm Devin O'Day. And oh my gosh, if we got so much fun stuff happening all over Middle Tennessee. Cannot wait to share with you. It's going to be fast and furious. You might even want to write some of this stuff down. First of all, we are going to find out about a place in Columbia, Tennessee. My friend Neal McCoy is going to be at the Mule House in Columbia, Tennessee, December 3rd. Autumn House's birthday, just saying. December 3rd, 2021, and Neal is so fabulous. And I bet a lot of you don't know about the Mule House. Music in Mule Town, Columbia, Tennessee, is on fire. My friend Blair Garner used to do overnights. Blair Garner Midnights is just, he was known all over the world, still is. But he's got a place that he opened just following his dream. And on this show, we love to celebrate the people who are following their dreams.
My name is Blair Garner, and this is what I know. Deep down inside of you, and deep down inside of me, lives the person that we know we can be. The person that lives to dream, that lives to hope, and the person that lives to love. Somewhere along the way, though, we got tripped up. You know, we listened to the people who told us that we weren't good enough, that it wouldn't ever work. They said that we couldn't do it. And before long, we replaced the word can with can't. And little by little, those dreams, our world of possibilities just slipped further away, and we just gave up. But today is the day we draw the line. Today is the day that you and I reach back for those dreams. The day that we summon the courage to turn our dreams into reality. It's the day that people start to see for the very first time the version of ourselves that is courageous, that is strong, and that is determined to make tomorrow better than today. Because today's a new day. It's another chance to get it right.
Gosh, I love his voice, don't you? Blair Garner is part of the Mule House. The Mule House is a theater in Columbia, Tennessee. And on December 3rd, Neal McCoy will be there. If you have not seen Neal McCoy live, you are missing out. He was just in Branson, Missouri. And we've got a little bit of the crazy man himself live on stage. Hope you get your tickets. You can find the Mule House on Facebook. And of course, Blair Garner's wonderful webisodes called The Mule House are incredible. You just got to take a look.
Some men are attracted, and soon their big blue eyes. Ooh, change their pretty face. Well, just to make their temperature up. Sun very important is not sitting on the cake. Now, what really turns me on? Ooh, let me shake. Shake it to the left, shake it to the right. Come on, baby, you know why. Shake it, feel fucking, shake it up. Shake it till you can't shake it no more. It's a natural attraction. In combination with New York State. What really turns me on is thank you.
Going to sell out the Mule House in Columbia, Tennessee, December 3rd. Don't miss that date. Oh, I love stories. Dr. Phil Wink from Delta Dental of Tennessee has so many great stories, and it's heartwarming and good, the things that they're doing and how important a smile is.
I was going through a really hard time in my life. I was missing 12 teeth. I would cover my mouth. Mentally, it was so draining to have to constantly worry about who's gonna see it, because your first impression in somebody is their smile.
Delta Dental of Tennessee and the Smile 180 Foundation, transforming lives and communities one smile at a time.
My smile gives me my voice. My smile gives me my passion. My smile gives me my drive. My smile gives me everything.
Donaldson Hermitage Chamber of Commerce invites you to our second annual holiday market at the Mansion, presented by Gaylord Opryland's A Country Christmas at the historic Two Rivers Mansion on McGavick Pike in Donaldson, Tennessee. November 19th and 20th from 9 a.m. to 4 p.m., you can shop over 50 unique vendors, get your gifts wrapped, a photo with Santa, pick up some grub with the fantastic food trucks, and listen to live music. Oh, and you can get a Christmas tree all before Black Friday and all shopping local. Don't miss it.
Sitting here in front of the Troubadour Theater.
Yes, we are.
With Dean Holman from Music City Hayride.
Woo! How are you doing? Glad to be with y'all.
You have got the big show. The finale is going to be about to take place.
You bet we do, on November 12th at 2 p.m. right here at the Troubadour Theater in beautiful downtown Nashville. And free parking.
Free parking. Music Valley Drive is a place that I have loved forever, mainly because of the free parking. Also, the food is incredible around here. But tell me who's going to be on the show and what you do at the Music City Hayride.
Well, we got a lot of our regular staff of independent artists, myself, Alan Carl, Tina Patterson White, a stack of them. Chuck Hancock's going to be here for this one.
You know what I love is that you always have such a connection with the veterans, and you've always done so much to give back.
That's the whole idea behind this thing. Was it started out just for the veterans, and now we've added the Shrine Hospitals for Children, too.
Ooh, such a good cause.
You know, I've been a member of the Shrine for 25 years, and I figured, yeah, they need it, too, because, you know, we aren't doing the parades we used to do, and they need the funding, too, and I'm proud to do it every year now.
Absolutely. Well, we want people to know about this mainly, too, because it is a matinee, which is one of my favorite parts of the thing. It's a matinee. You guys don't even have to drive after dark, which I love.
Yeah, and when you're over 40 like me, Notice I said 40?
I know, I love it.
you don't have to worry about night blindness, because you can get out of here, but in plenty of time to get home while it's still light.
And you can even grab dinner on your way home.
You bet you can. And if you want, stick around and go to the opera afterwards.
Yeah, that's what we do. Where can they get tickets for the Music City Hayride?
Well, you can get them online at musiccityhayride.net and then go to the tickets, or you can get them right at the door. And we usually have plenty of seating here. So if you don't feel like ordering online, come on down to the theater that day of the show and step right in, and our lovely little Susan will be more than happy to give you a ticket.
One of the things that I love too is that there is plenty of seating, but have there been any changes to the Troubadour with the new ownership as far as how the seating looks?
Well, the seating is 100% different. The pews are all gone now. There's only one or two pews in the place. It's all table seating. And I'll be darned if they didn't find a way to put some adult beverages into this place too, which is kind of fun too. It makes a lively thing. And they got some food and stuff in here you can get now, you know, hot sandwiches and things, which is real nice.
So it is the Troubadour now.
Yep.
And the musiccityhayride.net is where you get your tickets. And the last show, if you want to get your tickets, is November
12th. And we got Diane Sherrill and Hawkshaw Hawkins Jr. to close out our show. And I'm bringing in a gentleman from Wisconsin that I used to work with years ago, Congressional Medal of Honor winner.
Oh, wow.
And we're going to have him here with us on this show. And that's going to be great.
Dean, thank you for all you do for this community.
You betcha, Devin. I almost called you Donna.
That's okay, Dale.
Well, if you live in Hermitage or in Mount Juliet or travel the eastern part of Davidson County, you pass by this building behind me every single day. But I recently found out something about this building that I found fascinating, and I wanted to share it all with you guys. And it is that McKendree Village Towers right here in Hermitage is the largest building between Nashville and Knoxville. And for some reason, I find this absolutely fascinating. When you tell people that, what reaction do you get?
Really? Yeah, they're surprised.
In what way?
Well, I mean, it's not something you really think about, I think. And then just to know it's something that you pass by every day, it's special. And plus, McKendree is special because it's been here so long.
Do you start thinking about what's between Nashville and Knoxville when you talk about this being the tallest building? Because I did. I'm thinking, what's between here? And there's nothing.
Yeah, there's nothing on I-40 clear to Knoxville.
How long has this building been here?
This one was built, it opened the doors in 78, so 43 years.
Exactly how tall is this building?
205 feet.
205 feet. Story-wise is?
17.
17 stories here. All right, so McKendree Manor's been here since?
Since 1963.
63. This building?
This building, 1978.
All right, so when you were first told about this, was your reaction mine? Like, that can't be true, that this is the tallest building.
Yes. Yeah, that was my reaction. I was like, we have some history on the wall. We have a historian, and she did a little history, and it's been the tallest building for the longest time. And so I acquired the information, and I share it.
You had a great point, because you come here every single day.
Yeah.
I drive by this building every single day. So we kind of take it for granted, don't we?
Correct.
Yeah, and then, so it's been a vital part of the community all these years.
It's the heart of Hermitage.
When you come up here, what's the best view for you?
For me, I love the view of the Hermitage.
Why is that?
It's beautiful. The fields and the old houses, it's gorgeous.
Now, again, there are no special tours to get up here on top of McKendree Towers. We got permission to do this. Just take our word for it from the pictures. It's pretty stunning from up top here at McKendree Towers.
Joe Dubin has a morning show, Mornings on Main Street, and it is fantastic. 7 o'clock every morning on all of our Main Street pages. And we're on YouTube, Main Street Nashville. Make sure you click subscribe and hit that bell. Every time they go live, you'll know about it. Josh Kiser is going to be in Hendersonville, part of the When Pigs Fly extravaganza. Parks and Rec in Hendersonville has put this together, and it is this weekend, this Saturday, Lots of great stuff going on and lots of wonderful entertainers and lots of great pig. Let's talk about the barbecue. It all benefits Christmas for Kids. Tickets are $75. When pigs fly, pigfesttn.com to get all your information. And the Department of Parks and Recreation, along with a lot of great sponsors like Lippman and Half Batch and Ultimate Party and Meat Sweats Barbecue, all part of the Hendersonville Pig Fest coming up Saturday, November 6th. And if you don't know Josh Kiser, I tell you, he's one of my favorite ones to come out lately. And I just love sharing his music. And I hope that you like this. We're going to share a little bit of his right now. And I really think you're going to like it.
Y'all, this is Josh Kiser. I'm with the Out Here Co. tailgate sessions. I hope y'all enjoy. So this next song right here is God's Been Good to Me, and this is the first song that I ever actually wrote in Nashville with a good buddy of mine, James Otto. And it was the first song I ever got to put out too, so pretty proud of this one. I hope y'all enjoy it. This old house, but I know payday's around the corner. Boss came through with some overtime. I've been saving nickels and saving dimes. Life can test your face sometimes, but everything's gonna be just fine. God's been good to me, ain't no doubt. Can't count all the blessings he sit down, helps me up when I can help myself, save this sinner from a living hell. Well, God's been good, yeah, and I believe every night I get on my knees saying, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. A little blue-eyed blonde took my name. Life since then has never been the same. Now we got a baby girl on the way. God's been good to me, ain't no doubt. Can't count all the blessings he's sent down. Helps me up when I can help myself. Save this sinner from a living hell. Well, God's been good, yeah, now I believe. Every night I get on my knees saying, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord, for God's been good to me. Whoa. He sent down, helps me up when I can help myself, save this sinner from a living hell. Well, God's been good, yeah, and I believe every night I get on my knees saying, thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord, cause God's been good to me. Yeah. Oh, God's been good to me, yeah, He's been good to me,
Pigfest, pigfesttn.com to get all your information, your tickets. Hendersonville, Tennessee, Parks and Recreation of Hendersonville, bringing you Marty Rabin and Rockland Road, Lindsay L, Tim and TJ Watson. Of course, like you just heard, Josh Kiser, Will Waykaser, hosted by Whiskey Jam's Ward Gunther and Hendersonville resident. Going to be fantastic. Other things coming up, don't forget, in Spring Hill, November 5th, that's tomorrow, 6 p.m., ballroom at the Park Winchester Building. We've got Miss Cassie, and she is going to be teaching dance lessons for $10 per person. First 10 signups are free. To get your name in Spring Hill, Tennessee, reservations 931-703-2203. That's ballroom at the park. A whole lot of fun. They've got, if you don't have somebody to dance with you, it doesn't matter. They're going to have somebody there to dance with you. It's going to be so much fun. Mule at Christmas, Lebanon, Tennessee. That's this Friday and Saturday. If you want to get your Christmas shopping on, let's talk about the craft fair at McGavock High School. McGavock High School Orchestra bringing you in Music Valley Village, November 6th. If you saw Big Joe in the morning, this morning, yesterday, whatever, did a story with McGavock High School Orchestra's if you call them a band parent, they're the orchestra parent. Anyway, they have got handmade decorative crafts, all sorts of great stuff. A great new location, Music Valley Village on Music Valley Drive, right over there next to the Troubadour. The parking is free. McGavock Orchestra Parents Association bringing you the craft fair this Saturday. Save the date. Head over to Gallatin, November 20th for the Christmas Harvest Craft Show. That is coming up. And don't forget, on Saturday, I'll be hosting Backstage Nashville at 3rd and Lindsley. It's going to be so much fun. 12:30. It is a daytime show. And the Christmas Shop open in Mount Juliet now, and they are doing Christmas pictures with Santa. You do need to call ahead and make reservations. It's not just a show up and get in a big long line. You need to make some reservations and dress your kid up real cute and take those Santa Claus pictures at the Christmas place. It's just kind of awesome. Now let's talk about gospel music. Friday, Bluegrass Gospel Showcase at the Troubadour. 4 o'clock, the doors will open. Let's see. I don't know who is going to be there. It's going to be so much bluegrass gospel. We just can't even shake a stick at all this. Look, they're going to open the opening prayer at 4:50. Sam Jackson's going to be emceeing with people like the Bush family and the Bluegrass Gospel Association. Travis Whitehead's coming in from Louisiana. Jackson Hall from Michigan, the Welkel family from Commerce, Georgia, Cooper Bennett from Athens, Georgia, Camp Meeting Singers from Morris, Alabama, the Southern Travelers from Colton, Georgia. Then they're going to have an award ceremony. Then Kenny Stinson and Perfect Timing. They are so good. And of course, they're from Franklin, Kentucky, where lots of bluegrass was just brought to us. Gospel Gold from Oakdale, Louisiana. Crystal River Bluegrass Gospel Band from Jefferson, Georgia. Judy Marshall from Nashville. Golden Valley Crusaders from North Carolina. The New Godspeed from Walton, Kentucky. The Chestangs from McIntosh, Alabama. And the Burning Bush family from Red Level, Alabama. And then they're going to have a big sing-along grand finale at 9:45. And then you can head on home. Because that's the way we roll. Or you can do like I would do and head over to the scoreboard and see what kind of music they got going on over there. It's going to be such a good time. I have had more fun finding good bluegrass gospel to share with you. And I found a little band. This young lady is so good. Oh, my gosh. Where is she? Let me see if I can find her here. Oh, her name is Courtney Patton. And Modern Trade, they do a lot to celebrate the new members of Bluegrass. And I thought, I just got to share her because she's just fantastic. And I think you're going to like her. Just write her name down. Her name is Courtney Patton.
Oh,
Thanks to Modern Trade for that video. And her name is Courtney Patton. And it's a new grass, and it is gospel grass, and it is awesome. And we want to celebrate the new people coming into the genre and what they bring to it. Because if you don't celebrate the new young folk coming into a genre can die. I mean, it really does. So that's why we celebrate Bluegrass Gospel. And it's coming to the Troubadour on Friday. Well, if you don't know what else is happening this weekend, you've had your head in a hole, because a lot of folks are waiting to see the return of Yellowstone. Season 4 is a-coming this weekend. The time is going to change, and Yellowstone is coming back to Paramount.
Hey, you're John Dutton, aren't you?
Yep.
That's not mine.
It's addressed to you.
Wait, I don't know what that is. Don't. Casey!
Officer down! We got an officer down!
Jesus Christ.
Casey!
Don't you die on me now. Not like this.
You hear me?
Oh my God.
What's happening?
I don't know. Just get to the bunkhouse.
Fair. Moral. Those are words men invented to scare and shame other men from taking back what they've stolen.
Oh, what about right or wrong?
There's no such thing.
Yellowstone 2-hour premiere event, Sunday, November 7th at 8, exclusively on Paramount Network.
This Way of Life is a song that I wrote. It's inspired by an idea given to me by my friend Taylor Sheridan. We were out here on his porch and looking out over the valley, and we were talking about the cowboy way of life, the Western way of life, and what it means to us. We're both Texans. We're just both raised in that way. He said, you know, there ought to be a song about that. I said, yeah, there ought to be. So I figured I might as well write it, and I did. It took me a few months, but I was sitting around one day, and I finally came up with something, and I recorded it and sent it to him, and he really liked it, and they're going to use it in Yellowstone, so I'm really excited about that.
From last season, that is Garrett Bradford, a wonderful artist. I hope you'll check him out. We're going to close things out, and it's a big weekend for premieres. We're going to tell you about a lot of the premieres coming up, and I hope that you're watching Wendy Moten, one of our time jumpers. It's a Monday night must-see at 3rd and Lindsley on Monday night, the time jumpers, and Wendy Moten has been a part of that for the last year. She was on the road with Vince Gill, Julio Iglesias, and she is kicking butt on Team Blake. And so we'll have some highlights from that, and maybe we can talk to Kenzie Rose, who was part of The Voice this season, did a beautiful, beautiful job. But that's all the time we got today. So be safe, be kind, remember you are loved, and have a great rest of your day, everybody.